Rolf respects your vow to uphold the sticky notes of elders, yet... you must be punished.
What is that, Rolf?
The hat of discipline. Do you live in a cave? All is forgiven.
Thank you, Rolf.
Hello, everybody. I'm Coco Cosmos, and in this video, I'll be talking about one of my favorite shows in the world, Ed, Edd N Eddy. This show is very near and dear to my heart, as I watched it every night when I was a kid sleeping over at Grandma's, with a comfy blanket, ready to see what trouble the Eds would get into that day. I was definitely seated when I heard the iconic
Ed, Edd N Eddy!
Almost like I was hypnotized. Oh, how I love this show. Let me count the ways.
Don't touch that dial, kids!
In this show, there aren't any bad or evil characters. Just imperfect, which makes the cartoon super interesting to me. They're all just kids navigating wacky hijinks, with the Eds just trying to make a quick buck, or the cul-de-sac kids just trying to have a semi-normal day. Double D was my favorite character in the show. He was smart, loyal, and the voice of reason for the group. He gave a good balance to Eddie's short-sightedness and Ed's impulsivity. I was a curious kid and a big science nerd growing up, so I could relate to him a lot. I also liked the way he didn't know everything, because at 12, you just don't. For instance, he knew all things science and vocab, but when Ed asked if moms were girls, he was stumped. He was very book smart, but when it came to people skills or crushes, he lacked a bit. His cleanliness was also a plus, so I felt bad for him during the episode where his shower was getting renovated, and he just kept getting filthier and filthier. I've also noticed that he was the most liked Ed by the neighborhood kids, as he doesn't cause as much trouble or destruction, on top of him being very polite. Rolf is also a character that I was very fond of. As a boy from a small village being integrated into a modern society, he's bound to have some weird traditions. He doesn't celebrate Christmas, as his people have a special holiday, and he gifts very unique trinkets to everyone. What made me happy, though, is he was chill with everyone, including the Eds. He even let Ed stay in a shed in exchange for farm work until Eddie started interfering. His colloquialisms were also super interesting and quotable. Like, his roles were unmatched. Dude was hilarious.
You have resurrected the dispatcher of despair! Let it be on your head!
You can't be mad at the Eds, specifically Eddie, for chasing a bag. The only goal they had was getting a jawbreaker, and they moved heaven and hell to get to it. From building a homemade coaster to literally making their own city for the neighborhood kids. They always had some sort of plan. Now, if the plans worked, that's a different story. I always rooted for them. The gag of them just using whatever they can find laying around in the garage or when they hang out at the junkyard was super creative. Because, you know, kids usually don't have money. One of the things I enjoyed was that there was gross-out humor, but it wasn't overwhelming. Kids like gross stuff, but it wasn't every other joke like some modern cartoons. And the slapstick was impeccable. It had me crying. The Wish You Were Ed episode was one of the best displays. And whenever Ed used his absurd strength to destroy things, with trees and houses, you could hear me across the house. That being said, though, the episode where Ed turns into a real monster was one I wasn't a fan of. Because when we found out he was covering the kids in chewed up Chunky Puffs, I was disgusted. But it was still on par for something the targeted demographic would enjoy. The fourth wall breaks were always something satisfying, too. One of my favorite ones was when Double D suggests a reasonable solution to their problem, and Eddie responds with,
"And ruin the plot?"
And let's not forget my favorite part, the art and animation style. Everything didn't look pristine and perfect, and it was my favorite thing. Watching the squiggles on the screen brought me comfort. And recently, I learned that they're called boiling lines. Look, I'm not an animation expert by any means, so don't make fun of me in the comments. The squash and stretch and facial expressions were so amazing. they conveyed everything so well. Like, you knew that shit had to hurt. Everything was so big, and the sky truly was the limit. The Eds always had some adventure during the summer. Like, this show was my Phineas and Ferb. I always wanted to find some way to make money when I was little, or I wanted to build something too. I feel it the most when I rewatch the school episodes, though. They first started to air around the time I was in second grade, so when I watch them now, I truly feel like my 7-year-old self again. Especially the one where Eddie wants an endless summer, because that meant endless scams. So he changed everyone's calendars to make them believe it was July, but actually, school is supposed to start the next day. This is one of the few shows that reminds me of the fun of being a kid. Let's talk about some of the episodes that I loved and some that I didn't care for because, hey, nothing's perfect. It all starts when Eddie gets irritated at Ed's gravy obsession and bets him that he can't go a day without it. And Eddie yells at him in response. Double D bets that Eddie can't go without yelling all the time. Afterward, everyone starts joining in. The best part was Eddie sabotaging everyone else and him losing so Ed wins by accident. This one was just super boring to me. I will say it was interesting to see the kids choose future professions and the twist of it all being a dream from his childhood. I also read that this was going to be the original ending to the series. It does present the fear of growing up pretty well, though. The slapstick was on target. After Ed ruins all of that day's plans, Eddie tries to make sure there's no possible way he can ruin this. The spa thing was going well, though, until, you know, interference. And it all comes crumbling down. Literally. The only part I liked was Ed yelling at Sarah, and her being like, oh, this is serious. But, as someone that has walked around with a pebble in her shoe before, I get it. An absolute classic. I cannot stress that enough. The Eds, mostly Double D and Ed, try to do a nice thing for Rolf, but when Rolf finds out he's been tricked, he uses Ed's enthusiasm against them. The thing is, it's still a consequence for Eddie and his scamming, but in a way that's not completely malicious, as Ed is just having his fun and so is Rolf. The imagination in these is so vast. We see everyone's imaginations and how they think and how they can perceive the world around them. In the Once Upon an Ed episode, we see that Double D is, of course, more logical. Ed tells things being more sci-fi and unusual, and Eddie's is just him stroking his big ego. With the Know-It-All Ed episode, we can see how playing pretend can get super out of hand. With Eddie trying to be a dictator-like sheriff and the Canker Sister bandits starting to take over. Jimmy was just too soft for my liking. Like, yes, I get it, your feelings are hurt, you feel humiliated, I get it. Genuinely, I do. Every character in the show is super exaggerated, and that makes the show work, but I think this was a bit of an overreaction to a wedgie. Especially since Double D and Ed were punished when they didn't even do anything except be Eddie's friends. When everyone except Sarah was laughing at him. Like, Kevin and Johnny need to get a lashing too, if that's the case. How is a 12-year-old babysitting another 12-year-old? Eddie and Double D were also kind of weird for assuming it was a date, but who would assume he was getting babysat? Ed and Eddy debuted on January 4th, 1999, and ran on Cartoon Network for 10 years, which makes it the longest-running original series of the network. It was first pitched to Nickelodeon, but the creator, Danny Antonucci, declined because he wouldn't be given creative control. I'm glad, honestly, because we clearly wouldn't have gotten the show that we have today. It definitely wouldn't be as memorable. And why is it so memorable, you may ask? Well, because of some of the things I've already listed. The animation style, the sound effects, and the writing doesn't treat the kids like they're dumb. It helps kids think about things like how being different is cool or how to be a good friend to your friend. This also makes it rewatchable as you get older because you can still relate to some of the emotions conveyed, especially in the big picture show. Speaking of the big picture show, it's a perfect ending. No reboot needed. We've gotten closure in all storylines. All loose ends are tied up. Bing, bam, boom, we done. And I know what you might be thinking. Wouldn't it be cool to see teenage or adult versions of everyone? Sure, but it's not necessary. It's best to preserve the greatness of something rather than trying to add to it and make it not as good. I'll make it brief because you've heard me ramble enough throughout the video about how much I love this cartoon. It was a staple in my childhood, and I still watch it to this day as a pick-me-up. It makes me laugh, brings me comfort, and very much brings me joy. Now, is it perfect? No, because nothing ever is. That doesn't make it any less great, though. Do you love Ed, Edd N Eddy as much as I do? What's your favorite cartoon? Let me know in the comments below. Coco Cosmos out!